Hey, what's up, everybody? Okay, it's New Year's. I made it. We made it. Okay. Y'all know what I do. This is what I do. I do what I do. I do. So what I'm doing right now is New Year's Day. We're in 2022. I tried to get all these readings done yesterday for all the zodiac signs up in New Year's Eve, but it is what it is, because this is the energy that is going to be, that you're going to be stepping into in 2022. So pretty much what I'm doing is the 2022 yearly forecast for you, and pretty much I'm gonna put a little twist to it, because what I'm gonna do is use my gifts and my ability to bless you. I'm using them to bless everybody, you know what I'm saying, because I've been so blessed. God been blessing me, making me feel so good, and I just been having so much to be thankful for. So what I'm gonna do is pay it forward, and I'm sending this blessed love and energy out into the world, and I'm gonna help y'all to manifest some of y'all heart, some stuff that you worked hard for, your some blessings into your life, okay? So you've been moving forward with good intentions, good heart, mind, body, spirit, doing things the right way, sending good energy out there into the world. This is for you. You know you ain't been doing that, it's not for you. You know what I'm saying? I'm just gonna keep it 100. This reading may not resonate with everybody, okay? And everything in it might not resonate with only one person. It's gonna be, it might be all over the place, you know what I'm saying? So only take what resonates with you. I am connecting to the highest vibrations of love and light, and my God, my creator, creator of all, most powerful of all powers that are to exist, to assist you with this reading. So let me take a sip of my drink and I'm gonna get to it. Okay. This reading is going to be for the zodiac sign of Virgo. Virgo, y'all are last for the way it's been going. I've been shuffling, y'all came up last, so it's, I'm saving it for last, you know what I'm saying? So let's go ahead and get it, Virgo. We got some good energy going on. Okay, what I, on my channel message to you guys, Virgo, because I know about, like, Virgo, it's very important that you use, that you, okay, giving is better than receiving at this time. Okay, that's all I got to say. I don't know. That's what I feel. Giving is better than receiving at this time. So peace, love, and light. This is my zodiac deck right here, so I'm gonna find y'all card. Venus, I believe. Okay, Venus right there, that's the love planet. Okay, might be Virgo planet. We're gonna see. Virgo's right here. Beauty, Virgo. Okay, let's go ahead and put this down for y'all, Virgo. Let's get to it. I found y'all zodiac card, and I'm going to place this right here while I do this reading. Okay, adjustments. So I'm also getting maybe adjustments are needed, okay, as you move forward, Virgo. Adjustments may be needed as you move forward, okay? So let's go ahead and see what's going on. We're going to start off actually with the Archangel Guidance Oracle deck here. And let's see what we have for Virgo. What's going on with y'all? I hope y'all doing good too. Yes, I do. I do. I do. I do. Peace, love, and light. I'm hearing I do. Is somebody getting married? Okay, all of my dudes. Peace, love, and light to y'all, Virgo. Let's go. Wow. Y'all. Okay, Virgo. It's time for you to take inventory of your life, to look at your life, take a step back and look at your life. It's what I'm getting here. Let's see. That's why I probably, when I said adjustments are required, and it just knocked that off. Something happened and something shocking, something just hit you out of nowhere, and it's letting you know that you need to make some changes as you move forward, Virgo. Okay? We got moon cycles here. It says, notice how the moon cycles affect your energy and manifestation so you can capitalize on them. You need to learn about how the moon works and how it works with you. You need to take some time out to do that too. Okay? I feel like you've been trying to manifest some things and they have not been working for you, but that's because you need to learn more. You need to gain some knowledge about yourself and your energy and how it is affected by the moon. We got breathe. Okay, breathe says take several deep breaths and exhale slowly to awaken your energy, to release old patterns, okay? So you could have been, you got some bad habits and doing some routine things over and over again that's not good for you, not healthy for you, and you need to take some breaths, some breathe, you need to breathe, okay? So you can release those negative energies that you the tendency to do things over and over again, so you can gain some new ideas or something. You could be going through a very difficult time at this time, even leading into this new year, Virgo. What I'm seeing is you're probably facing some or dealing with some heartache, some pain, some emotional hurt, okay? It says comfort at the bottom of the deck. You are being helped. You're being provided with the energy that you need at this time, the love and comfort that you need from your guardian angels. It says, I'm helping you in your time of need, helping your heart to heal, okay, Virgo? That's the underlying energy. And you just need to breathe. You need to relax, okay? Because something could have sent you into some negative patterns, some sort of situation that caused you some heartache or emotional pain. Sensitivity, okay? It says you are extra sensitive to energies and emotions right now, so honor yourself and your feelings, okay? You're feeling your own emotions. You're possibly feeling emotions from other people as well. Your child is what I'm getting. Maybe something went going on with your child or children. It's saying nurture. As you nurture a child, you nurture your own inner child. Both activities are important for you right now, okay? You're probably remembering some stuff from when you was younger, causing some triggering emotions and stuff like that. And you need to surround yourself with some gentle stuff at this time, because and give love to your child. Love your child the way you wish you would have been loved when you were younger, is what I'm hearing, or your children. We have relationship harmony here too. A relationship between you and somebody is probably strained. It says we angels are hoping to opening the hearts of everyone involved. Arguments and conflicts are being resolved now. So this is telling you that God is working on this. Your guardian angels is working on a connection that you have with somebody. It says it's time for you to assume your leadership power and position and lovingly guide others, for you to step up, because you have a bond with children. In particular, you can help children who are sensitive, Virgo, because you've been through some things that they can relate to, possibly. And you know, when you're around or in the presence of a sensitive child, you yourself can have a sensitive child or children, okay? It says crystal clear intentions. It says be clear about what you desire and focus on it with unwavering faith, okay? Don't focus on the bad thoughts, the negativity, the bad possibilities. Focus on what you want to happen, okay? We got clear sentence. It says notice the reoccurring physical, emotional feelings as they signify divine guidance. So notice the feelings that you're having in your body, your thoughts, and all that type of stuff, because it's letting you know whatever it is that you need to know. Okay, we're going to continue to move forward with this reading here. Also at the bottom of the deck, it says pay attention to your thoughts and ideas that come to you as they are answered prayers. So you probably pray for some help or assistance with something, and the way you are being assisted is by being provided with thoughts, and you need to pay attention. So you need your mind to be clear enough so that you can be receptive to receiving, you know, so that you can be receptive, so you can receive these thoughts and ideas that you are, that you're needing, okay? So I'm going to proceed with the energy oracle deck here, and we're going to see what energies are coming towards you, Virgo, in 2022. What do you need to be aware of, and how can you best navigate as you move forward on your divinely guided path to manifest these blessings into your life, okay? Peace, love, and light to you. Thank you for watching, okay? Thank you for being here with me. Peace, love, and light to y'all. We got envy in reverse. So this is a time for you to not be jealous of nobody else, okay? For you to not be looking at what's going on in other people's lives and comparing it to your own, okay? You need to take stock of your own life and the blessings that you have in your life. If you want to be very successful in your career or stable in life, is what I'm seeing here. You have divine wisdom and guidance, okay? If you are want to receive it, is what I'm seeing here. You could be a very intuitive person yourself, vibrating also with some very high energy, is what I'm seeing here. You could live a very lavish lifestyle, be very wealthy, is what I'm saying here. Very wealthy is what I'm saying here. You're not jealous of anybody. okay? If you're a very wealthy woman, you're not jealous of anybody because you have everything you can want and more. You have things that you don't even need. You actually are aware of all of the blessings that you have. You're just wanting to enjoy the life, the moments that you have in your life with your family. You wanting to take things one day at a time, take it easy, take in every blessing. You don't want to miss anything, is what I'm saying here, because you spent a lot of time building your life, building yourself up, building your career, and you're just wanting to enjoy the fruits of your labor, and you want to take it all in. That's what you're doing, is what I'm saying here. You're needing to have some time to yourself, free up some time. It's like you've been tied to a bunch of obligations, duties. It's like with business and stuff like that, opportunities that's been coming your way, you've been taking them, you've been very, very busy, but you're now wanting to be just free yourself up for some time to move forward. There are going to always be possibilities for money here, adjacent possibilities for money, doors to value, opportunities for you. You at this time, you're needing to take a break or something like that, or just clear your schedule for some, so you can enjoy more time with your family, okay? It's telling you to move forward with love and compassion. Don't have your guard up with hostilities in reverse, okay? Take a more compassionate and loving approach to your family and think matters of the heart, is what I'm saying, with woman holding the heart at the bottom of the deck, okay? Whether you're a man or a woman, you're probably dealing with a woman and she's approaching you with love or something like that, and you're needing to approach her back the same way, or vice versa. You need to just approach a situation with a more compassionate place, from a more compassionate place, is what I'm saying here. Take the leadership. It's what I'm saying here. What I'm seeing here is you're not really trusting your intuition at this time with Sixth Chakra, Archangel Metatron in reverse. This could be talking to somebody. It's many different people watching this video or going to see this video. What I'm seeing here is somebody needs to tune into their intuition, to do some chakra clearing, to get their self in a place where they're awake, okay? Because somebody is not... they're not taking a divine guidance. They're being very focused on elevating with their career. They're trying to see what's going on. So somebody is like, some people are made already and some people are on their way. They're trying to get on their journey. You're making a choice. You made a choice or a decision, but you were not guided to make the choice or decision that you made. You're needing to make a choice or a decision. You're not wanting to collaborate. Teamwork and collaboration is in your best interest. You're needing to talk to somebody, okay? It's like, there's a lot of success when you're coming together with other people who share your interests, who you have things in common with, who you can bounce ideas and stuff off with. You're wanting to connect with people who you can trust, is what I'm seeing here. You don't know who you can trust, and that's causing you to not be able to trust yourself, and that's why your third chakra is experiencing some block. When you don't trust people, it's because you don't trust yourself. You needed to trust yourself, okay? Woman holding the heart, come now. You need some healing. You need emotional healing, okay? And other healing as well. It says you need to focus on your personal happiness and healing. This is door to personal happiness and healing. It's not a time for you to really be giving your love to another person, but a time for you to love and nurture and care for yourself at this time, okay? A choice that you need, that you made, I don't know. You chose to put your energy into something else or somebody else when you should have put it into yourself. And as you move forward into 2022, that's what you need to do. Focus on healing yourself, Virgo. We got border value, okay? It come out in reverse, but I'm not going to take it in reverse. I'm going to take it for how I'm seeing it. I feel like somebody's rushing towards something, taking some action towards some new beginning that they feel is very prosperous or is going to bring them a lot of success. It's like you need to follow your spirit, okay? Follow your spirit guides. Ask God for help and guidance. Don't be afraid. You might need to travel. You might need to make some sort of a move with journey at the bottom of the deck. This is your life. This is your journey. Nobody can do this but you. There is somebody who does care about you, though. They love you. This person, you haven't met them yet. So look, that's that weird energy. You know what I'm saying? if this person is not somebody that's watching you or something like that, this is a person that it's like the situation where you believe you have a soulmate, right? And this is what I want to do for you. I'm going to help you with this. Say you feel like you know there's somebody out for you, there for you, but you don't know who it is. Keep that thought, right? You don't know who it is. Send that person love anyways, okay? Send that person love anyways. Breathe. You know, wish that person well. You know what I'm saying? Be positive about it. Speaking into existence that you will meet your soulmate and stuff like that. I feel like you're going to meet this person. You're going to meet somebody while you're out. You're on a journey. You may be traveling. You may be on vacay. I feel like don't overspend if you go on vacay, if you're somebody who's not rich or something like that. That's what I'm getting from that with the door to volume in reverse. You're going somewhere. It's not a love, or you're somewhere where there's not enough opportunity. So you're needing to travel to somewhere where there is. That's the truth. That's what it is. So up in 2022, you might need to make some traveling move. You might need to make some big moves, okay? It's like tune into your heart, into your mind, to know what it is best for you that you need to do, okay? Virgo. So my blessing to you, okay? I'm taking out my tarot of dreams, okay? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into your hopes, your wishes, your dreams. I'm going to dig deep up in there, okay? I want you to let me in. Don't be scared. Let me in, okay? Because what we're going to do is we're going to connect to God. We're going to connect to the highest vibrations of love and light. And what we're going to do is I'm going to assist you, and we're going to manifest those blessings, those hopes, those wishes, those dreams into your life. Now, these are the things that we're trying to manifest in your life. It's things that you have already worked hard for that may have been delayed or blocked. And we're going to try to bring those forward for you into 2022. And if we can't do that, we're going to bring in some sort of happiness and fulfillment for you so that you can be patient as you wait and continue to work towards those goals that you are wanting to fulfill, okay? Those blessings that you're wanting to enter your life. So, God, can you please assist me by showing me what Virgo's hopes and wishes for at this time? You miss somebody, Virgo. You want to reunite with somebody. Possibly a family member. Your relationship has been strained. There's been some negativity between you and this person. It's been very challenging for you. And what I'm seeing is you feel like this person is giving up on you. You watch this person. Okay, secretly you watch this person. This person is, you seeing this person as somebody who is healed and moved forward. I feel like you've been in a situation where this person where you betrayed this person. And I feel like you regret whatever it is that you've done because you actually love this individual. This may be a friend or a family member. Why I'm saying that stuff, I'm not just saying it. We got the six of, and this may be with your child. You could be having a difficult time with your child as well, or children. We got the six of cups here, okay? That represents nostalgic emotions, thoughts, okay? Like remembering things and stuff, but they're good. They're good things, and it's like, okay, you're at a place where you're possibly just ready to move forward, okay? The next card we got is the Nine of Wands, which is what I'm saying. Something's been very challenging for you, okay? This is something dealing with friends or family or in the past. You've been feeling strained. You probably strained a relationship with somebody in your family or your friend, a best friend or something. And this person is a soulmate, whether they're not a lover. This is not a lover, but it's a soulmate. It's a friend or a family, and it's a soulmate. Your relationship between this person has been strained, okay? The next card out is the Moon. There are secrets. You're keeping secrets, and they're weighing you down. But you're trying to hold up with the Two of Cups here. I mean, the Two of Pentacles here. It's like you got a lot going on, but you're not losing the vision of your where it is that your heart is taking you, where you want to be, what you want and what you desire is what I'm seeing here. Okay? That's what I'm seeing, Virgo. You could have been pregnant You could be starting some sort of a contract with somebody. You could want to be married in this year. You could be getting married. You could be making plans to move forward with some sort of creative project, or you're waiting on something. You're waiting on somebody, and they're damn near rejecting you. Somebody could be married, okay? It's like you're waiting. You may have thought something was going to bring you some damn wish fulfillment, and you was left with unrequited love. Like somebody did not return your love in kind, or it did not happen to work out the way that you want to, or it wasn't what you thought it was. We have you still looking forward with optimism, okay? And that's what you need to do, and you need to put the work in. Because the cards that I got coming out for you are the Empress, which is representing abundance. So you could be somebody who is very wealthy, like I said before. Okay? And you've got the Three of Pentacles coming after that. It's some sort of a contract or arrangement or agreement, or you have your own business. You're wealthy and successful. You have created this palace of coins for yourself. So this is you having a nice house full of luxurious things, beautiful things, a bunch of beauty and nature, love, green all around you is what I'm saying. Stability, security, most definitely. Okay, you're a woman of authority, very nurturing, very kind, very generous is what I'm seeing here. You could be having some plans that you're coming up wanting to do something new. It's telling you to go forth with those plans. So it's like I'm talking to many different people here, if whoever's reading this, looking at this reading, it's whatever it is for you. You're ready to move forward from the past because you feel like you're dealing with a soulmate or something like that, or you wanted to move towards one, or you've been dealing with a situation that's been very toxic. That's what I'm seeing here, and you've been needing some rest and some healing, and you're ready to move forward, okay? You're wanting to reunite with somebody who is your soulmate with the Two of Cups is here, or unite with one. We have something that's meant to be. You got to leave the past in the past. You have to follow your heart, okay? Somebody may have, is what I'm seeing here. There's some communication coming in or some forward movement. Something that is like going to make somebody sad or hurt or something, because somebody's following their heart, cutting somebody out of their life so that they can move forward and build a family is what I'm seeing here. We have the Queen of Wands here. This is about persevering. This is about with the Palace of Swords under there. It's like you're somebody self-made. Somebody has built their self. Somebody may be single. Somebody desires to be in a relationship. You have built your life on your own. You're not letting nobody come in and fuck nothing up for you. And you want to be in love with somebody. Okay, there's going to be balance coming into your life when it comes to a family situation, okay? Somebody's going to come into your life and bring balance into your life, okay? This is going to require you to this shit is crazy, because what I'm seeing here is somebody was betrayed. It's a third-party situation. If somebody's left out in the cold and stuff, somebody was. But there's going to be some help coming in the future, or in this year to come, 2022. Things are going to get better. But I feel like you got to be careful of what you accept from people, what you get from people, because with the Devil card coming out and the Ten of Swords at the bottom of the deck, I feel like somebody could give you something that you don't want. And it's possibly karma for something that you did. Or this is for somebody else in your life, okay, that did something wrong to you. But everything has to be balanced out equally, okay? It's what I'm seeing here. But it's telling you, Virgo, you're dealing with some very toxic energy, okay? That's what that represents too, the Devil card. But you gotta get out your fucking head and get the toxic shit out your head and have faith, okay? Have faith and focus on your self-love, your self-care, nurturing yourself. I feel like you thought you was gonna be together with somebody. You met your forever person before and you didn't, but you still have hope as you move forward that there is somebody out there for you. I don't know who I am talking to. I don't know who I'm talking to, but that's the energy that I have is what I'm getting here. I feel like shit, you got your own shit. You will be good on your own either way it go, especially if you a rich, very wealthy woman or something like that. We're going to continue to move forward with this reading here. Even if you're not, you're working your way up there. Continue to go. Continue to push forward. Okay, you're not there yet, but you're on your way there. That's how I'm feeling. So let's go ahead and keep this going with the light and the positive energy and the positive vibes. That's what I'm talking about, Virgo. So let's keep this shit going. And we're going to, this is the Work Your Light Oracle deck, and we're going to see how Virgo can best move forward and shine their brightest and attract the blessings that they desire into their life. Let's see. What does Virgo need to know from this deck of cards? What is the most beneficial messages from this deck that Virgo needs? Peace, love, and light. It says, share your voice. Come out of the cave. Persecution, expression. Don't be afraid to share your voice. Share your story, okay? It says, you have a yes. Just say yes, okay? Just say yes to something, okay? Peace, love, and light, Virgo. Don't be afraid to accept your calling. It says, your guidance is divinely guided. The guidance that you're receiving is divinely guided. You can trust the guidance. You can trust me too. I'm not here to harm you or anything. I want the best for you. Okay, so let's continue to move forward. It got keepers of the earth there. You're not alone, Virgo. You might feel alone in a lot of stuff that you're doing, but you're not. Call upon your ancestors. It says ancient ancestors stand beside you as well. And the thing about this is, Virgo, whatever it is about your path, you're meant to walk this path alone. It's a lot of stuff here. It's a lot of beauty around there. And it's like this person is walking. You can see it. It's one person. It's just one person. It's something that you're meant to do by yourself. This is your journey. And at the bottom of the deck, the underlying energy is align your life. What is not aligned and what is not, what does need to change? I feel like you need to focus on getting to know yourself, being true to yourself, being authentic, Virgo, shining your own authentic light, your own light, being yourself. Because I feel like with this person here, you see how that's like a mirror and it's their face and it's all these broken pieces. This person does not know who they are. They're losing themselves in whatever it is that they're doing. It's telling you to trust the niggling feeling, trust your intuition, like I said. It's like, don't push that shit away. And it's like, don't walk around acting like you awake and acting like you aware of everything if you not. If you need more knowledge, if you need to gain, go look up some shit and go get, surround yourself with people who know stuff, who are intuitive, who can help you to get into your, to connect with your intuition the proper way, then do that. Be true to yourself. Do what's best for yourself. Follow the feelings that you get inside your body. You might be going through some health issues and shit like that. And it's, you might feel like something wrong with you. You need to take a leap of faith and go get yourself checked out. You need to take a leap of faith. You might be feeling like it's time for you to, you've been holding yourself back. And you're feeling this energy like you're feeling so anxious or something. It's because you need to let it go. Whatever that's in you that you're keeping within yourself, that you're suppressing, that needs to be let out. You need to let it out. Your voice, it's a certain specific sound. It's something that's within you that only you could do for yourself, that you need to speak this, okay? It says this is something that's happening. Seeds were already planted and laid before you were even here, before you were born. We got Anna, the grandmother of Jesus. It says, seeding the light, laying the foundation, divine plan, okay? Divine plan. It's about God's plan. You know, you know you need to go on your journey. You know you need to walk a different path. You know you have to do that. This card is just out, and I'm going to pull it because it's turned over already. It says, dance with life. You need to do something to change your energy, Virgo. You need to do something. Get out, dance. Go dancing. Go out for some drinks. Not looking for anything. Not looking for anybody. But go out and enjoy yourself and do what you need to do to change your energy, because you're holding on to some negative energy right now. And it's like all these clouds. It's like you don't have no... It's because it's like you don't... There's smoke in the air. You don't know what's going on, but you have these feelings. You know you have your intuition, and that's what you're needing to tune into. You're going through a powerful transformation. That's what's going on. Things are changing on a cellular level, and you're needing some deep healing, okay? Priestess is at the bottom of the deck, is your underlying energy. It's how you're being called to step up and lead, okay? How are you being called to step up and lead? You need to get grounded, okay? Unbound. You need to free yourself. That's the underlying energy there. Free yourself from whatever that's holding you back, whatever that's It says release soul patterns, releasing soul patterns, contracts, and past lives, okay? Let the past go. You need to let things go. You need to release things and get yourself grounded. It says empaths. You could be an empathic person, Virgo. You could be an empath yourself. Highly sensitive. Connect with nature, okay? Get yourself grounded, okay? You see how she is? Get out in nature. Get yourself grounded, okay? Know where you are. I don't know where you are in the world, but try to get out, breathe, and connect with nature is what I'm hearing here, Virgo. You're an earth sign as well, so yeah. I see you could be very intuitive, but I feel a need to tell you that you might need to get out and connect with other intuitive people as well, so you can learn a little bit more about yourself and how to enhance your skills and abilities, okay, your gifts, how to use them, okay, so that they help you, okay? So, we're going to finish this reading up. We're getting to the end of the reading here, Virgo. Another one of the longer videos. I guess y'all needed the guidance, so we're providing it. What I want you to do right now is ask a question that's in your heart and in your mind. The question that's most important to you, that's on your heart and your mind at this time. Okay? Focus on that question. Ask the question that you want answered. Because what I'm going to do is connect with God in the highest vibrations of love and light. And I'm going to assist you by answering those questions for you. Okay? Providing you with any advice that you need along with it. Okay? I also need you to pick a number 1 through 3. Okay? Ask your question and then pick a number 1 through 3. Go ahead. I'm going to give y'all some time, Virgo, to ask y'all a question. I ain't going to rush y'all. I'm going to breathe a little bit so I can connect with the energy that I need to connect with so I can assist you by properly answering your question. So ask that question that's on your head, in your heart, and on your head right now, okay? In your brain, in your mind, okay? Pick a number 1 through 3. Don't pick too many numbers, okay? If you end up getting two answers, you might be confused because you can get a yes and you can get a no, and that could just put you in a confused state of mind. So 1 through 3 and settle on it, okay? Remember your question. I'm finna start. God, can you please assist me by providing the answer with question number 1, okay? God, can you please assist me while providing the answer to question number 2? Okay. God, can you please assist me by providing me with the answer to question number 2 for Virgo? Question, come on, y'all. Y'all doing the same thing somebody else was doing earlier. Okay. See, y'all got two. Come on. Y'all got to settle. Settle. Number 2. Whoever picked number 2, come on now. Get your question right. What do you want to know so we can provide you with the right answers? Come on. What do you want? What do you want to know? What's that question? What's that important question? Pick one question. Don't be all over the place, Virgo. Let's get it together. Okay. I understand. Now I understand. Okay. Whoever picked number 3, can we assist number 3? God, can we assist number 3 by providing them with the answer that they need at this time? Okay. Number 3? Okay. So we're going to get into it to answer your questions. We're going to answer your questions right now. So if you pick number 1, the answer to your questions is abundance. You probably asking what will await you if you do this, or what is this or that, or what this will bring or something like that. The answer is abundance. Okay, what you're meant to be, abundant, okay, blessed, fruitful, have a lot of blessings, gifts, okay, that's what I'm seeing there, happiness, fulfillment in your life, okay, think that way, okay, be that way, think that way, live it, own it, it's yours. If you chose number 2, the answer is wait, okay, and I understand now why, like, it was all over the place. 2 messages came out and stuff like that. And I'm like, settle, okay? It's because you're finding a hard time to actually even settle. So, you know what I'm saying? So, you need to wait. You need to wait until you and get grounded. So, and meditate and stuff like that. So, you can find the answers that you need. Tune into your heart. Because what I see here is you could be dealing with possibly I'm not going to even say that. But what I'm saying is you having an energy, similar energy to somebody else, and it came out in the same position, okay? You need to wait before you make a choice or a decision, because you could be burning and feeling ready to take action towards something. Because what I'm seeing here is this person surrounded by fire. Or you probably burning shit out of, and you want to tell and you want to say something, and it's probably not the right time. That I'm not trying to be funny at all. That I'm just saying. You, or you could be just ready to take some action that you need to find out some information or do some more planning and researching before you do it, okay? That's what I'm getting for number two, because I don't know what question you asked, but it's many different people asking many different questions. Everybody don't got the same question, but y'all picked the same number. So, we're going to number three. If you chose number three, it says look for a sign. Look for a sign. So, that means you got to be focused on it here and now. That's my advice. Pay attention to everything around you. Pay attention to signs and synchronicities, okay? 111, whatever, on the clock, 222, whatever the case may be, signs you see when you're outside, the thoughts and stuff that come to your mind when you see certain things that stand out to you, okay, as you move forward. With that being said, Virgo, I hope y'all got everything that y'all need from this video. I hope it serves you well as you move forward on your divinely guided path into this year of 2022. I send y'all peace, love, and light, and I hope that everything that we have laid down here for you, with the things that you want to happen in your life, comes to fruition for you, and that you find the help and the healing that you need as you move forward. So peace, love, and light to y'all, Virgo. Take care.